Hi, welcome to the CAD NEST. I'm Kantharaj from NAGAR branch. So today I'm going to teach you how to apply the VLOOKUP function for student mark list. So in the student mark list, here we have the result and average. So in the result, you can see the first, second, pass or distinction as per the average. For example, if the average is 0 to 35, then he is considered as fail. If the average is 35 to 50, then he is considered as pass. And 50 to 60 second, and 60 above it is first, up to 85 it is first, and more than 85 it is considered as distinction. So for this, we were using previously if condition. So we can apply the VLOOKUP function in student mark list also. So here, I'll show you how to apply the VLOOKUP function. So is equals to VLOOKUP, open the bracket. So VLOOKUP is nothing but a lookup value, table array, column index number and range lookup. So range lookup is now used now, since here we are comparing the numbers to the text. Here we are comparing the numbers to the text. So no need of using the range lookup. So the range lookup is used when we are comparing the text to the numbers. So here this equals to VLOOKUP, open the bracket. Lookup value is average, comma, the table array. Select the table array, comma, column index number is 2, and close the bracket. So for the table array, we need to press F4, select the table array and press F4, so the dollar symbol will come. It seems that it will remain constant. It will remain constant. These cell letters will never change, since if you drag the formula, so instead of M3 it will change as M4, M5, M6. So the table array should remain constant for all the cells whenever I drag the formula. For that purpose, select the table array and press F4, then it will remain constant. So enter the first place, drag the formula, so you can easily find out the result formula by using VLOOKUP. Observe 79 it is first place. Observe 68 it is first place. Here it is 38, it is pass. So this is how we are going to use VLOOKUP in student mark list. So in the next class I will teach you how to use the range lookup also for other data base. Thank you for watching.